is ready to get the second half going. Mike Hogwood, Mike Jaminski back with you in College Park. And G-Man, you talk about this first half, you have to talk about Greivis Vasquez. Not only did he score, but he did so many other things to help his team in that first half.
As he's done throughout the whole year, Mike scores, leads the conference in assists, really does a great job in all areas, had a block shot in this game, very active. And you know, what can you say about it? He's right. He's a player of the year candidate in this league.
And when he comes out and starts shooting the ball like that, it's really infectious. It gets everybody else going on his team.
Especially for an early game, it's critical to come out with a lot of energy, and he's provided that throughout his whole career, knocking down the threes, but then also creating for his backcourt mate, Eric Hayes. Nice job there in the fast break, really making much better decisions this year. He is the unquestioned leader of this team.
Well, in the huddle now, you see him there and talking to his team along with Gary Williams.
If you look at Vasquez and Hayes, they've combined for 23 points and 9 assists, which accounts for 41 of the 44 points.
Before we start the second half, let's get a quick word from Debbie.
Well, I had a chance to talk to Coach Williams on his way out of the locker room. Obviously, he's disappointed in the defensive effort. Wide open three-point baskets. He respects Maryland's three-point shooting ability, but they got to make him put it on the floor and turn them into passers on the perimeter. He feels like if they can get the ball inside, they have the advantage with a bigger front line. Deion Thompson was effective early on.
Thank you, Debbie. Well, you knew 9 of 16 from 3 was not going to make Roy Williams happy at all in that North Carolina locker room.
Well, it's all about, you know, the perimeter defenders and covering guys and keeping sight of where shooters are. That's the thing about, you know, you put pressure on a defense when you can put multiple weapons out on the floor. And really, Maryland has 3 or 4 guys who can shoot the three.
How about that? On the opening possession, the Terps knock it away, come up with a steal. Williams on the floor, held ball, and the possession arrow will be to Maryland. What an aggressive way to start the second half for the Terrapins.
And a disappointing start if you're Roy Williams to look out. You've gone over some things. You probably scripted out what you want to have happen in the first couple of minutes. And the very first time you handle the ball, you turn it over.
Sean Mosley got a hand on it. Here's Hayes. Hayes had 3 threes in the first half. Clock is under 10 for Maryland. Here's Milburn. The kick out to Vasquez. Short, and Davis showing some athleticism. Guignard from the corner. Marcus Guignard with the three, and what an offensive game he's having here today. That's his 10th point. He's in double figures.
Since coming back from that ankle injury, it averaged only 3 points per, and this may be the breakout game that Marcus Guignard is looking for.
That's just a tough, tough shot. And Drew comes up hobbled just a little bit.
Well, that's what makes him such a tough matchup. He can shoot the three, and he can use his size to get into the lane.
Thompson can't hit it.
That's what Roy Williams is talking about. He got position but didn't finish.
What a pass. What a pass from Greivis Vasquez to Jordan Williams.
I really believe Jordan Williams is going to be a factor in this league as he goes throughout his career. Really has blossomed as his freshman year has gone along.
Guignard, 7 assists now in the game for Greivis Vasquez. Here is Williams against Davis. Jordan Williams, 6'10", 260. He is a load in the paint. Milburn got the block. Milburn, the leading shot blocker on this team. He's had a couple today.
Well, here's Vasquez doing what he does well. Getting the ball back and getting into the lane, making things happen. There's the finish.
Maryland with 6 unanswered points here in the last minute.
Roy Williams not happy with Ed Davis's defensive effort in this early going.
John Henson in the game for him. Thompson got his own rebound and put it back. Deion Thompson has 7 or 9 points rather.
He's been very active here. He's taking Roy Williams' halftime speech. reach to heart.
And good defense by the Tar Heels. Here's Ed Davis on the bench. 8 double-doubles this season, but not a lot lately.
Well, in two consecutive plays, he got outrun down the floor by Williams, and then the other one he played behind him kind of lazily and let the ball come in, and Jordan scored both times.
Thompson. Count the bucket, Deion Thompson.
And this looks like the Deion Thompson that came to play against North Carolina State over there in the win in Raleigh. He was very effective. He really got them fired up in the second half. 11 points, 4 rebounds for him. Here's the nice possession. You see the double team coming down from the top with Mosley, and he just turned away from the baseline.
And trying to complete the three-point play, Deion Thompson. He had 20 points in that North Carolina win at NC State, and playing much like that, as you said, here this afternoon. This is what they've been looking for from Deion Thompson on a consistent basis all year. Hayes fouled. Nice drive to the bucket by the senior, Eric Hayes. Marcus Guignard picks up his second foul.
The other thing about Maryland, the balance that Roy Williams talked about, you have the great three-point shooters, and you also have four of the starters who are excellent free-throw shooters.
Thursday, NASCAR's back, and speed is in Daytona for a pair of races on the high banks. Be there as the field is set for the 500. The Gatorade Duel at Daytona Thursday at 2 o'clock Eastern, only on speed.
I don't know. I've never heard the building that quiet for a home player shooting free throws. I don't know if I'd like that. It'd be a little disconcerting.
Ball fake by Graves. Guignard, who's come out firing in the second half.
Different player, you know, it's like, and now I can guarantee you he's forgotten the last seven games and how they've gone. It's a new beginning for him.
Two threes here, both in the second half. 13 points for Marcus Guignard. Lost out of bounds by Williams. A different day for Marcus Guignard.
You know, where he was for the past seven games, he was hoping that that one would go in. The difference is today, he knows it's going in.
Redshirted last year after surgery to repair a stress fracture in his foot. He's missed time this year with an injured foot. Graves. Look at Guignard chase down the ball, the senior. Showing some leadership. Hanson. John Hanson to the rack.
John Hanson.
What an aggressive move by Hanson off the left hand.
We have not seen that a lot this year.
No, I think that he got a lot of confidence in being sent into the game early in the second half. 10-2 run for North Carolina.
And the lead is now just 5. Gary Williams has called a timeout. 16:04 to go. The freshman, John Hanson, giving the Tar Heels some life.
Second half action, Maryland with the lead. Now let's hope we have a game like we had last year here in College Park. Let's flash back to last year. The signature fist pump by Gary Williams, because the All-American Tyler Hansbrough's in the house. Ty Lawson gives North Carolina a 16-point halftime lead. And then Maryland starts to come back, down 9 with a minute 39 to play. And Grievous Vasquez starts to take over. He's going to finish this game with 35 points, 11 boards, 10 assists, the third triple-double in Maryland history. Maryland wins in overtime, 88-85, snapping a 10-game North Carolina winning streak.
And it was a great game last year. In this game, a 10-point Maryland lead at halftime went to 13. But North Carolina has come back. Gone on a run now and cut it down to 5.
Maryland, the only team last year, Mike, to beat both of the teams that play for the national championship, Michigan State and North Carolina. Of course, Maryland made the NCAA tournament last year. And I looked for early on in the season like that wasn't going to happen, but they righted the ship and had a terrific year.
Vasquez can't hit it. Hanson lost it, and a good block by Deion Thompson.
interesting matchup. Henson has been very effective on the defensive end, and he may be a little more suited to play Milburn in the open floor.
Dexter Strickland, the freshman in the game. Here is Thompson, fouled on the turnaround shot by Jordan Williams. It'll be the second foul on Williams. And Deion Thompson really asserting himself this afternoon for the North Carolina Tar Heels. 52-47, timeout on the floor. Really looks to be totally healthy here this afternoon. And Deion Thompson is the first of two. Let's go back over to Dick.
Well, one of the things that Coach Williams told me before the basketball game was a sense of urgency that you know seniors come with. Well, you can see in the second half that Deion Thompson and Marcus Guignard are bringing that leadership and that sense of urgency to both ends of the floor. It's important to Roy Williams that his seniors lead these young guys.
Debbie, it's a 12-2 run now for North Carolina, sparked by those seniors who would love to get a road win here today against the Maryland Terrapins. Get their season turned back around. Guignard now on Vasquez. Guignard's reputation, a great defensive player. Shot clock winding down, and look at Hayes. Eric Hayes, a great drive to the bucket.
But I think that's part of the game plan. I mean, we talked about, Debbie talked with Roy Williams about it. You've got to make those three-point shooters drivers. And it's he's got 13 points in the game so far, as Hayes. But I think you try to let him chip away two at a time rather than three.
Cliff Tucker back in the game. He commits to foul. It's his first. Tucker, as we told you, has made a living scoring against North Carolina. He's got 7 points. Here is Graves, Tucker defending him. And Will Graves, you don't see that a lot from Will Graves, taking the ball to the hole like that.
No, he's normally a standstill jump shooter as well. But he was a marked man for Maryland. They want to identify where he is out on the perimeter at all times.
Vasquez right to the bucket. Nobody cut him off. Boy, that's just Strickland's got a lot of speed. Good defense by the Terps to block that. Here comes Vasquez. Up strong for the dunk. It's blocked. But Dino Gregory will go to the free throw line. There's a lot of muscle underneath the bucket there.
Well, I tell you what, both Maryland centers do a very good job of running the floor. And Vasquez, again, if you're a point guard, you've got to hold the ball until your big man is ready to receive. No dribble right there. He can catch, take a step, and go to the rim.
Second foul on Will Graves of North Carolina. And Gregory, an excellent free throw shooter. Gregory on the year now, 23 of 26 from the line at 88%, as Ed Davis reports back in from Carolina.
Made a game-saving defensive play down in Florida State, taking a charge on Michael Snair.
Gregory, the junior from Baltimore, hits them both. He's got 4 points. Tar Heels break the pressure and have numbers. Graves left it short. Last touch by Will Graves. It'll belong to Maryland. Tar Heels did a great job that time of getting by the Terrapin pressure. And again, Graves, Vasquez driving through traffic, but this time, Guignard comes up with it.
You know, he's going to make 4 or 5 plays a game that's going to have Gary Williams shaking his head a little bit, but you have to live with that with him.
Look at Henson. Graves. Will Graves showing some ability inside that has not been seen a lot this season.
Well, the Maryland coaches were worried about their post players, but it's been on the offensive glass here in the second half that North Carolina has really made a mark.
And Davis down with that rebound. Graves now in double figures with 11. Here's Guignard. That's a block. Gregory whistled for the foul.
Fouls on
to look inside. This is just effort, and Henson really uses his length that time. It's a long rebound, but he plays over the top of everybody, keeps it alive for a teammate.
Marcus Guignard to the line. He is 3 for 5 from the charity stripe so far in this game, as Larry Drew will return. David Ware, number 34, there into the game, and you see Landon Milbourne headed to the Terrapin bench. Guignard makes 1 for 2. He'll get a break as Leslie McDonald is in. We're approaching that 12-minute media timeout, and Roy Williams trying to give some of his starters added rest here.
And just really, I think, reinforcing stuff with Marcus, and nice little bit of coaching right there.
Great shot in the paint, Dino Gregory. And a steal by Vasquez. That's what the senior gives you every game for Maryland. He comes up with a couple of really big plays that have big impacts on the game. Inside of Bowie. And look how high Henson got up on to get that rebound.
Yeah, and a lot of times I've seen him in games where he really gets ignited playing well defensively, and it helps give him some confidence down the other end of the floor.
Gets it inside to Davis. Here's McDonald for three. Vasquez the rebound, and look how quickly he gets it in transition. Hayes open. Eric Hayes has 4 threes in the game.
Right in transition and off offensive rebounds are the best ways to get open looks, and that's the first one they've had in this half.
Larry Drew might have gotten a little out of control. Vasquez on the run. Really looks frustrated over on the North Carolina bench. As Maryland's taken an 11-point lead and another Carolina turnover. Bowie fouled by Larry Drew. And Maryland's gone on a run, and this crowd has exploded here at the Comcast Center. The Terrapins out double digits, 65-54. What a great pass by Vasquez. Eric Hayes, he has been money from behind the arc. Vasquez leading his team here in the second half. Maryland up 11. Gravis Vasquez, not only 20 points, but Mike, he's got 8 assists as well.
Now you just look at it, really, he's just been controlling the basketball, but making great decisions all game long. Finishing inside, great passes out on the break.
North Carolina had closed the Maryland lead to 4 points at 58-54. It's the last time they've scored.
17 assists on 24 made field goals. That's outstanding offense.
Here's Strickland. Ware with the shot. And the Tar Heels have gone cold when they can ill afford it. Vasquez for three. Gravis Vasquez, 23 points.
And the reason he took that is because Jordan Williams runs the floor, and he's got the offensive board covered, so Vasquez felt comfortable taking the shot.
10 unanswered points for Maryland. Travis Ware. Nice drive to the bucket by the freshman from Huntington Beach, California, and he'll go to the line. John Henson. Some long faces on that North Carolina bench as they cut that lead down to 4.
Hey, you see Jordan Williams right down the middle of the floor. He makes a commitment to run in perfect position, and that allowed Vasquez, who's already seen a big basket, gave him some freedom to take a shot on the run.
Travis Ware has not been to the free throw a lot this year. His only his 20th free throw of the season. You see David Ware coming out of the game. Ware hits them both. And a again, his offense is starting to come around for North Carolina. Ooh, and there's a foul off the ball, and that's going to be on
Mike, there are
Graves, there, Will Graves.
There are four or five times during the course of a game where you'll see the opposing team pick up a foul on either Hayes or Vasquez when they're moving without the ball and just grabbing a jersey.
Oh, what a pass. Vasquez spotted Dino Gregory all alone.
Talk about plays that can't happen. They had the one pass for a three on the underneath out of bounds, and then that one for a dunk.
Good ball fake by Guignard. Didn't take the shot. Guignard misses off the glass. Here comes Vasquez and the Terps again. Off balance. A big run for Maryland. And North Carolina's in a little trouble here with 9:47 left.
You see that snap pass and the dunk inside. Ware just had his back to the play, lost vision for a second, wasn't expecting it.
The Tar Heels have Deion Thompson back in. They need him on the floor. They have gone 3 minutes and 15 seconds now without a field goal. And you see the run at 12-2. Back it out and set the offense. 10 on the shot clock for Maryland. Oh, way to split it. Defenders there. Here's Mosley. Sean Mosley, and Maryland can do nothing wrong right now. Look at that crowd.
You know what, Mike? The thing is that this team, they're leading the conference in scoring, and I think if you ask most fans in the ACC, they might not know that. How good they are on the offensive end of the floor.
Three threes from Marcus Guignard. You saw that shot of the crowd a moment ago. Almost 18,000 have braved the icy conditions to come here today.
Well, we can't describe how bad it is outside, how the roads are. So this is a terrific home court.
Another three from Gravis Vasquez. He has six threes today. What a performance. Ed Davis, the offensive rebound, can't get it. Good defense by the freshman, Jordan Williams. Ed DeBuey drops it for Mosley. This the largest lead of the game now, and Roy Williams has called a timeout. 77-59, an 18-point Maryland lead.
They are headed to well over 100 points at this pace, Mike. This has been a very explosive game for the Terrapins.
8:12 left. Well, and that was a great break.
Yeah, and just held a good timing on that. Mosley with a good finish. The emotional leader of this team, Gravis Vasquez.
Let's go over to Debbie Antonelli.
Well, you were talking, Mike, about Matt not knowing that Maryland is so good offensively. Here's a couple things about Gary Williams you might not know. Only two other people have won more games in the ACC than Gary Williams. That's Dean Smith and Mike Krzyzewski. He's 65 years old, 42 years he's been in the business. He started as a high school coach, and watching him in practice yesterday, there's no doubt in my mind that he is a tremendous teacher who loves to be in the gym with his players.
Eight consecutive 20-win seasons, and I think we have to mention Bud Milliken, who passed away this year, who was Gary Williams' coach, and he says taught him so many things, the fundamentals of the game of basketball.
And this was a coach, despite that gaudy resume, was under fire last year and turned things around. And he's, you know what? And I said it on the broadcast on Thursday. It is hard to coach at your alma mater, and he has done a marvelous job.
Larry Drew fouled. He'll go to the free throw line when we come back. It's a tall uphill climb right now for North Carolina. From For more on one of Maryland's freshmen, let's head over to Debbie Antonelli.
Well, Jordan Williams is a 6'10 freshman. He's from Torrington High School in Connecticut. He averaged nearly 36 points a game in high school, but it wasn't quite near what our G-man can do. Jaminski, Mike Jaminski, Massac High School, averaged 40.1 points a game, the state record in Connecticut. And G-man, we know that you skipped your senior year to attend Duke early, but he broke Calvin Murphy's scoring record.
And I talked to Jordan the first time I met him. I said, you came close. And he looked at me, and I didn't know I was from Connecticut, but we had a lot of fun with that. And I don't know if that's an indictment of Connecticut basketball, but that record still stands.
Are you kidding me? 40 points a game? It'll live forever. And I'm sure most of you know that Mike Jaminski had an unbelievable career as the center of the Duke Blue Devils in the ACC and then on to a great career in the NBA.
As you can tell, I've got a different barber now than I did back then.
Yeah, but at least you still got hair.
Yeah, good point.
Well, the freshman Jordan Williams missed that shot. Deion Thompson gets around Williams, and Thompson again is having a very good day for North Carolina. 16 points. Greatest Vasquez today with a double-double already. 26 and 10 assists. Here's Mosley. Gets the roll.
You talk about a versatile player. We talk about Vasquez, but Mosley, he's got a double-figure assist game this year, a double-figure rebounding game this year, and several double-figure scoring games. So he can do a number of things out on the floor.
Ginyard, the other end. Look at Williams, strong for the rebound. Hey, you talk about Mosley and that overtime loss to Wake Forest. You mentioned rebounds. He had 13 rebounds in that game. Milbourne is back. Vasquez is back for Maryland. There's Sean Mosley. 2 years ago, he was the high school player of the year here in the state of Maryland as Thompson takes a seat.
I know it's early, it's the halfway point, but this Maryland team is building a very, very solid resume for the NCAA tournament.
Williams inside.
Mosley making the play again, showing you what he can do.
Ginyard for three. He's been hot. Missed there, but Marcus Ginyard, three threes already today. Point lead here is the largest of the game. 5:47 left. Again, when you talk about the ACC race, you now really have to put Maryland strongly in the picture.
And if people were underestimating this team, they were sorely wrong. They've proven that they are right there at the top of the conference. This is a very explosive offensive team and a very sound defensive ball club as well.
Many of the polls had them in the top 25 at the beginning of the year. They had a lot of respect nationally as Davis is fouled. Here are the standings we're talking about. Maryland and Duke with just two losses.
Wake Forest, a nice overtime win at Virginia yesterday. And quietly, Virginia Tech sneaking into the conversation as well, Mike, sitting there at 5-3.
Just picked up his fourth foul. And we'll get a teaching moment from Gary Williams.
The one constant phrase with him over the course of the year is that Jordan Williams has a very high basketball IQ and absorbs everything very quickly. And they can see his progression week to week, not year to year.
A 20-point Terrapin lead. Padgett just in the game. He's fouled. James Padgett, another freshman from Brooklyn, New York. He is not had a lot of time lately, but he's shown a lot of potential.
Sixth on the team.
Thursday, NASCAR's back, and Speed is in Daytona for a pair of races on the high banks. Be there as the field is set for the Daytona 500. Gatorade Duel at Daytona Thursday at 2 Eastern, only on Speed.
Mark Martin in the pole position for Daytona 500, the oldest pole sitter ever.
Makes us feel good.
And Junior up front with him, too.
Yeah, a lot of folks think this is going to be a different year for Dale Earnhardt Jr.
It needs to be. And he's got everything in place. The Hendrick organization behind him.
And the most popular guy in the sport, bar none. Here's Milbourne. Game's gotten away from the Tar Heels just a little bit. It was a 10-point game at halftime.
And that was a feature that Duke has had in the past, North Carolina has in the past, that explosive quality where they could blow out 15 points before you even turn around. And I've seen that today from this Maryland team.
North Carolina had it down to a 4-point game at 58-54. Davis. And he's fouled. Foul's going to be on Mosley, his first.
Well, I think, you know, for your North Carolina looking for things to take out of this, I believe that this can be a springboard for Marcus Gingrich, and they need that for the rest of the year. He's had a terrific game. He shot the ball very well. I think this has gone a long way in repairing his confidence, 17 points for the game.
Yeah, Gingrich, those 17 points, and again, had not scored in double figures in his last seven games, so an important day for him as the Tar Heels try to regroup for the second half of the regular season.
Think about it, Mike. This loss leaves them with 10 losses on the year already, 13-10.
And would send them to 2-6 in ACC play. Another good pass by Vasquez. Paget, though, has his shot blocked by Ed Davis. Drew. Larry Drew has not scored a field goal today. Ed Davis wide open underneath.
Nice find inside Davis, making two nice plays on both ends of the floor. The block defensively and then shaping up, getting good position on offense. Double for him, 10 points, 14 rebounds. But he's not been dominant in this game.
Milbourne over Henson. And there's Ed Davis with his 15th rebound. Larry Drew, who is 0-for-6 in the game. Gignon. Milbourne all alone. Landon Milbourne having himself a great day here today with 17 points. .313 left. Largest lead of the game right now for the Maryland Terrapins at 88-65. The Terrapins have done very little wrong here today. Gravis Vasquez, the assist. Tucker has scored, and at the defensive end, they've been awfully strong. And now find themselves up 23 points. Maryland hit 9 threes in the first half, and a 10-point halftime lead. North Carolina cut that lead down to 4 here in the second half. But since then, it has been all Terrapins. Now up 88-65. And Milbourne down with the rebound.
How about Vasquez? His last two games against North Carolina, Mike, 61 points, 16 rebounds, 21 assists.
Had a triple-double here last year in the Terrapins win. You're right. He has been phenomenal against Carolina Blue. Strickland Dexter Strickland's first field goal.
And that's a snapshot of his game. Very good at, very fast out on the open floor. Very good at getting to the basket.
I get the feeling Dexter Strickland, Tom, he's a junior, sophomore, he's going to be really tough.
Well, how would you like, it's your first year ever playing point guard and you're a freshman in the ACC. That is no small task.
And still everybody's comparing the North Carolina point guards to Ty Lawson, which is unfair.
Yeah, that is just, you just happen to follow one of the great players in the history of the conference at that position.
Under 2 minutes to play here, and it looks like the Maryland Terrapins are going to get their 16th win of the season.
How about Eric Hayes with the ball right now? 16 points on six shots.
How about Maryland going 6-2 in ACC play?
Half a game in the win column behind Duke. We had a nice victory up at BC yesterday. Very hard-fought game.
You know, and now a lot of eyes will point as Maryland on Wednesday is home against Virginia. But next Saturday, the Terrapins are at Duke. That'll be a big game.
Always a great game. No regard for what either team's record is at the time. It will be played at a very high level.
As a matter of fact, some of the crowd behind us starting to shout, "We want Duke." There is that schedule we talked about. And again, next Saturday, the big one. As Hayes comes out, Vasquez is out getting a hug from the coach. And well deserved.
And I don't know for Maryland if it'll, you know, I just remember the games back in the early part of the last decade when Maryland and Duke were winning national championships, and those games during the regular season were classics.
Well, Milburn's had a great game as well, and Padgett is in, Tucker is back in, and how about Mosley? Defensive play, the steal and the slam, Sean Mosley. Almost an exclamation point on this game today. 92 points scored by Maryland. What an offensive output.
Wow, and this is a very tough team to stop, especially at home. And we outlined the defensive numbers for North Carolina in their wins and losses, and there's your player of the game.
Our touch of Gray, winning touch. Gravis Vasquez, double-double, 26 points, 11 assists. And how about those numbers last year? 2 years against North Carolina, he has been phenomenal. What a senior season Gravis Vasquez is having.
And really resurrected in his first four games, averaged 7 points a game, and just kind of got some things straightened out and has been absolutely fantastic ever since.
Yeah, I think the interesting thing is that it is after those games, in his last 17 games, he is averaging well over 20 points a game and had a great output here today. Boy, the Tar Heels still wonder what will happen. This is a team that came in having lost 4 out of 5.
We have 1 minute to play.
We'll make it 5 out of 6. The only win in that stretch at NC State. And we're under a minute to play. North Carolina, Mike, will fall to 2-6 in ACC play. Who would have thought?
Well, I mean, Mike, you look at it, and they were very young, and they were very unbalanced right from the start of the year, meaning a lack of perimeter play. And I don't care who you are, you lose 4 first-round picks. In the NBA draft, and you're gonna take a hit. You're not gonna just, you know, brush that off and step right out and come back and play for the national championship again.
And you've got to believe that some of the expectations were a little unrealistic for North Carolina. You're right. Not only do you lose those players, but you lose a guy like Tyler Hansbrough, who was just so dominant.
Well, and the Zeller injury hurts them, and the Ginyard injury hurt them earlier this year. So there were a lot of things that were working against them.
Clock winding down, and Maryland will get a 92-71 win. An impressive performance from Gravis Vasquez, Also in double figures, Landon Milbourne and Eric Hayes. This is a team to be reckoned with.
Partner is a great subbing in for him. I had a fun last couple of days. I really enjoyed it.
What I appreciate the most, folks, is Mike Jaminski's driving in the snow. Impeccable. He is excellent. You can tell he has a lot of practice. Well, North Carolina, G-Man, let's talk. Where do they go from here? I mean, this is a team that's obviously down a little bit now, and what do they have to do to right the ship?
Well, Duke on the horizon, and that game is going to be special, as it always is. And, again, I saw it with Marcus Guignard. I saw a positive today with John Henson. I thought he gave them a nice contribution. Deion Thompson in the second half. So, I mean, it's just – and I know that Roy Williams is going to keep coaching him, keep teaching him. And, they just come out and play until you get it right.
Maryland tied their season high with 12 points from three. Coming up next, it's women's Pac-10 hoops, USC and Stanford. Next Sunday at 7:30, ACC Sunday Night Hoops presented by Pizza Hut as Florida State and Boston College. For now, for Mike Jaminski and Debbie Antonelli and our entire crew, Mike Hogwood here saying so long from College Park, Maryland.